Editing AVCHD files takes a lot of processing power. I'm going to show you the performance of a couple of different systems. One's a dual-core processor, one's a quad-core processor, and show how they work with AVCHD. This first system is an AMD dual-core processor at 2.2 GHz. I've got 4 gigs of DDR2 RAM installed, but the system only recognizes 3.4 gigs. I'm running Windows XP 32-bit. The video card is a NVIDIA GeForce 6150 LE. This is an integrated card. It's not a standalone card, so it doesn't have its own dedicated video RAM. This is shared RAM. Okay, so here's an actual project. This is a 720p AVCHD clip, and this is how it plays back on this computer. You can see it's very choppy. Not so good. Okay, you can see if I scrub back and forth, it does not update very often. It's kind of hard to see what I'm doing. Same thing if I shuttle. Trying to fast forward. Good luck. This clip is 41 seconds long. I'm going to go ahead and export it to H.264 format. There's no preset that matches this properties exactly, but I'm going to choose the closest one here and then adjust the frame rate to match my clip. And I'll accept the rest of the default properties. So I'll start the queue and we'll see how long this takes. You can see my system performance here during rendering. My CPU usage is at 100%. I'm using 2 gigs of page file, which is never a good thing. That's always a lot slower than regular RAM. Okay, so this is just wrapping up, and it's taken about 4 minutes, which is about 1/6 real speed, because this clip was 40 or 41 seconds long. So here's my new computer. This is an Intel Core i7-920. I've got 8 gigs of DDR3 RAM installed, and I'm running Windows 7 64-bit. This system has an ATI Radeon HD 4850 video card. It has 1 gig of its own dedicated video memory. Here's what happens when I drop a clip onto Adobe Premiere CS4, the same clip as I was using before. It's nice and smooth on my computer. I can see it nice and smooth. It might look a little choppy in this YouTube video because I can't get this screen capture software to record at a full 30 frames a second, but it looks pretty smooth to me. When I scrub back and forth, you can see it's a lot smoother than it was. It's still not perfect, but it's an improvement. When I fast forward with the shuttle, it's smoother, definitely a lot smoother than it was, but still a little choppy. Alright, let's see how long it takes to export this time. I'm going to do the same settings as before, H.264. I'm going to choose the closest setting here and adjust my frame rate and accept the other defaults and start the queue. We'll see how long it takes. So here's what the task manager looks like during rendering. I have 8 separate CPU usage graphs because I have 4 core processor and each one can run 2 threads. This is wrapping up at around 52 seconds, which is a little slower than real time because the clip is 41 seconds long. On Adobe's website, they mentioned how Premiere Pro can take advantage of ATI stream technology. And on ATI's website, they mentioned that you need 2 things, ATI Catalyst driver and a plugin for Adobe Premiere Pro. But when I try to install the plugin, I get this error message that says the software is only licensed for AMD systems, and that the installation ended prematurely because of an error. So if you want to use this ATI stream technology, you're going to need an AMD processor.